deputy in Canyon. E peço que tenha sido presidido. Ну, давайте, значит, я начну с некоторого количества определений. Ну, к сожалению, как и вообще, наверное, в любом докладе, где речь идет о юнгианах или о каких-нибудь такого типа объектах, приходится пойти на компромисс, то есть я все-таки полностью... Значит, полностью от начала до конца определение юнгиана давать не буду, но просто скажу, что это такое.
Я так и лучше понял.
Вот, начало. Хорошо, значит, пусть же простая. Я буду считать, что G присоединенного типа. Присоединенная группа, но иногда буду пользоваться ее универсальной накрывающей G словом. Значит, мне понадобится алгебра Ли этой группы.
Можно потом что значит присоединенного типа.
Фактор по центру.
Ну, простая.
Да. То есть самая маленькая из групп с данной простой алгебры. Значит, же это ее алгебра Ли. Значит, с этой алгебры Ли можно связать. Значит, что это за объект? Это алгебра Хоффа, ну то есть это квантовая группа, то есть это алгебра Хоффа. Которая является деформацией, но на самом деле она является деформацией нескольких причин. Значит, то есть это, с одной стороны, это деформация, во-первых, универсальная дёргающая от алгебры топов на прямой с значением. Ну, значит, это универсальная обертка, вот сейчас бесконечно мерная алгебра Ли. Конкуренция группы.
Тимче.
Соответственно, отображение из формального диска в группу G. This is by EBW theorem, and this is because we mentioned that this is an exponent of the tangent space of infinity. So this is. So there are several ways to define a Jungian by generators and relations. And in fact, there are at least three different presentations. So let me briefly mention all of them. So in fact, one can take some generators of either this one or this one and deform the relation between them, right, to define the relation for the Jungian. So the first way of doing this is in some minimalistic choice, you can take this and this as the generating subspace of this Lie algebra and write defining relation on them. That is, this is the adjoint representation of this G with respect to adjoint action. And there is some one little more complicated relation saying that the commutator of this with itself is something anti-symmetric. So it is, anyway, it is a copy of lambda 2 of K of G. But so if we write relation here, we have to say that lambda 2 of G contains adjoint representation and some complement. And here we just annihilate this complement. When we define the Jungian, we do not annihilate this sum. Rather, we say that this is equal to some cubic expression of G. This guy. So in fact, there is only invariant way of doing this. Let me skip writing the formulas because it's okay. So this is so-called J realization. Now the second one. Simply connected group. sum over all domino integral weights in lambda times in lambda c lambda is a matrix element of irreducible representations. So, in particular, the functions delta meter p for p gradient in lambda star in lambda defined as they span this coordinate. And such functions gives a series of functions here. So from delta meter p, you can construct which is so we have infinitely many functions just by taking Fourier coefficients of this guy characterized as a function.
Say GLM, okay? Then yeah. G of T is a matrix whose coefficients right. MCS, mm-hmm. and then you take vector and apply extension matrix. And so how do I
just take matrix element of this matrix. Mm-hmm. This is some power secret. Mm-hmm. And I can take matrix element in any representation. Such functions as generators of the coordinate minima of the concurrent subgroup, and I can deform the relations between them. So in fact, let me see. declare how to do this. What is good here is that I can deform this system of generators in such a way that the co-multiplication doesn't change. So co-multiplication on this algebra is given just by Maverick's product, which is convolution, and for Jungian will be the same, but the multiplication will be different, and for this I need some additional proof. Which are an analogous to the following thing. The universal Delta algebra of E of T has the evaluation modules given by the homomorphisms. In terms of these realizations, this means that I take just the lambda as a module over this part and define the action of G of G as U times this, but this works for this fine for G of S of N, but for the algebras of other types, in fact, this requires adding something more to this representation. Because just putting this leads to some contradictions. But we can repair it by adding something.
But for SLN, you mean?
There are evaluation modules for the
end. You don't have to add anything.
I don't have to add anything. And the cool thing, the cool category of
said that there's like no real visualization representation, you have to add some finite dimensional pieces.
Right.
Ah, okay.
So the next property of this category is the following. That is, this category is not symmetric. So you can take tensor product of these guys. For example, P lambda 1 of P1, tensor P lambda 2 of P2. But in general, this is not isomorphic. At least just permuting the tensor factors is not an isomorphism of representation. Rather, you have a homomorphism from here to here, which is meromorphic in P1 and P2.
This is an isomorphism.
This is a homomorphism, which is an isomorphism for generic P1 and P2. Non-generic, it is not. Here, R of P1, R of P2, and the most important thing is that the analog of break condition on this R, namely that if you want to permute three factors, you can do this in two different ways. First, permute this, then this, or vice versa. So you have a product of three R's, which equals another product of three R's. Now, so from this structure on the category, I can get some generators of the Young, namely, I can get have the following morphisms for any representation of the Yang-Yang.
Thank you.
have this young Boxer equation, which means that if I add one more tensor factor, E mu, well, E1 to 1. And I can either first permute these guys, then permute these guys, and then permute these guys between themselves. Or I first permute these guys and then do this. So this means that I have the following identity in the tensor product. So what is real? I have this triangle tensor product. So the R matrix is sitting in the product of these two factors. Tensor 1 from here. T1 sits in the tensor product of these two guys. And 1 here. And T2 is in the tensor product.
In terms of small t, you can substitute, take this metric, capital T as a matrix in the small t.
Yeah. So I can take a basis in the lambda. On the other hand, I can take just just any any non-trivial representation to generate everything. So if V is non-trivial, then the matrix elements of these quadratic relations define Youngian of T tensor of one of T and so on, such that this is well just polynomial algebra in complete dimension. This is theorem of, I guess it was known to Grimsel many years ago, but it was made available by Curtis Hamilton recently. So now let me give an example. I can take G as S of n, and I can take the standard representation of S of n as the defined representation. Then the R matrix CN is just identity plus C1. And this gives me an algebra generated by Fourier coefficients of Tij, Jr. Thank you. In fact, I'm starting from epsilon here, but what I get is Jungian of epsilon under some center, which is Jungian of here.
So the relations are.
This is well-known defining relations for Jungian of TLM, which was known for ages before. Okay, so so I have this algebra. So now I forgot to mention thing that these are analogs of deformations of delta. There is some natural family of maximal commutative subalgebras in the Jungian. On the other hand, is it, well, I have to make this is the representation of the Lie algebra, which is not necessarily not necessarily makes.
You are saying that Lie is the representation of the Yang, not of the Lie algebra.
Yeah. Well, I can construct such T only from representation of the Yang.
Of the Lie algebra. So you need the group to act on this representation.
Right, but this is always so because if I take a finite dimensional module of the Lie, then this finite dimensional module of the algebra and it integrates. But not necessarily to the adjoint group, so I have to take this. On the other hand, in fact this algebra depends only on the image of this C in the adjoint. In fact, the only thing is used here is, the two things I use here. First, you have to use arbitrary relation, and the second, you use G invariance. But this is conjugate.
Do you need some assumptions on this?
I need just this. So, in fact, here I used the
But if seen in the group, then this is the case.
Yeah, yeah, this is the case. So from this I get many communion elements in the young man. And in this example, actually, I have just traces of C times C of U. So let me assume C of the diagonals of 1CM. I mean that the evaluation representation Cn of U doesn't have any subquotient, for example, in the tensor in its tensor square. Rather, there is a submodule in this tensor square. All such power series, all Fourier coefficients of such power series generate some commutative subalgebra. And in fact, for any C regular in G, generated by all possible.
is in fact a polynomial algebra. So the assertion is that I have run G infinite series of generators. So in particular here, I say that the Fourier coefficients of all these guys are algebraically independent and generate this from units. Now the main problem I work this on is to describe all possible generators of this. So we get a family of commutative subalgebras depending on the parameter C. And the problem I want to address is the following. I can degenerate this space where C is non-compact. So I can try to take some limits of commutative subalgebras from this family when C goes to infinity in this non-compact space. So let me say an example.
Isn't that what happens so if C is not regular?
Then this algebra is smaller. Some of the Fourier coefficients are the same. So the sample is just 2. Then I have only this series of generators. All the Fourier coefficients of this series commute, but I have the condition that the determinant of C is not zero. So now I can watch what happens when I drop this. So I can get in the limit. did. So, when C is, for example, 1, 0, 0, 0, then the subalgebra is generated by T1, 1. Here we see that one can extend this family of commutative subalgebra to C. So here you see that this subalgebra does depend on the on such markers up to scaling. So. And one can extend this family of commutative subalgebras to all C from the projectivization of two working matrices. We should keep free. Thank you.
should we take a prioritization of fundamentals?
Yeah, sorry. Set of simple roots, I can assign a pair of parabolics. This is positive parabolics and the lady subgroup, which is a reductive quotient of any of them. Reductive semi-simple quotient. Then the G times G orbit is just this homogeneous space, where P plus x here and here on the left, and P minus x here and here on the right. So this is some bundle over this. So this time is a bundle over the product of partial flat bracket plus I times P minus with the fiber in particular the smallest orbit is just G mod P times P mod. And first thing, I can say what corresponds to generic point here. So the generic, I mean that there is an open G orbit. Whose points are just pairs of Borel's subgroups, P plus and P minus, in general position. Pair of points in general position. So, to such pair, I can assign a triangular decomposition of the group, M plus, T, M minus. And to such decomposition, I can assign a Cartan subalgebra in the Yankian. And this is what corresponds to this point. So the Cartan subalgebra in the Yankian is a degeneration of that. So, and in general, more general strata, this similar thing happens. So I can regard a point from this product as a pair of parabolics P plus and P minus. And if and I can say what is the limit better subalgebra if P plus and P minus are in general position. Then P plus intercept P minus is is some Levy, which is GI plus some Borels. The beta subalgebra corresponding to such point, P plus P minus, and then another from GI. Is the beta subalgebras in the Yankian of GI of Levy subalgebra inside Yankian of GI. And the parameter of this beta subalgebra is So, So on the one hand, we get almost nothing new because any limiting subalgebra is described as a better subalgebra or product of better subalgebra in some smaller Young-Yangs. But on the other hand, we have some algebraic family of algebra. With all this as a family. And now, maybe I have one minute to state the general problem. So this family of algebras, even extended to the continuum Cartesian closure, is not flat family. Because we have property only on the regular part, and it preserves on some regular locus on any stratum, but there are some bad points where the functorial dimension drops. This means that if I take some C which is not regular and take some limit C equals C naught, this limit is not well defined. It can depend on the way you're approaching this point C. So if you want some true parameter space for better algebras, it should be some further resolution of this decontinuous shape.
So you mean this really happens, yes?
And this really happens, and I can give an example. So, for example, for SL2, well, we have this P3, which is a projectivization of 2x2 matrices. And in this P3, I have a point corresponding to and the true parameters in the space is the blow-up at this point. So I would expect that we have some stratification of the continuum purchase different from this. Something like stratification by dimension of centralized element. And the true parameter space should be some some iterated blow up according to this stratification.
So you're saying that for any point of this blow up, you can construct the corresponding cohesive solution?
Yeah. And that is relatively easy because. The fact that the better subalgebra is generated by tau u c, which is tau this point. And it depends on the direction I am approaching.
And in this case, it happens only for the identity
matrix. Yeah, yeah. So for the identity matrix, yes. So for the point on the exceptional fiber, the subalgebra is just better subalgebra of unity plus one additional generators sitting one additional just any element from.
But you don't have to blow up anything outside G itself, yes?
I hope so.
But in this case.
In this case. So on the boundary, don't blow up. So I have only. In fact, we have only conjectural and partial answer for this question, namely. We can describe the closure of regular points in the torus, in the maximal torus, and what we get is the following. So this is indeed a blow up. First we can take the closure of T in the decontinuous Frochetti. This is a toric variety corresponding to the band formed by Weyl chambers. And then we have an arrangement of subtori on this T formed by all root subtori. Arrangement. And there is standard procedure used in the continuum procedure of making this arrangement of subtori to be with normal crossings by blowing up something here. In fact, you have to blow up all irreducible, all decomposable intersections of this with subtori in this term. And this is what we need. But I still have no idea about the answer in general. So what you have to blow up on the continuum processing closure of the group. So this is some very natural resolution of the continuum processing. This complete time, no? Okay, so thank you very much.
I have like a psychological question. So, before you gave a lot of talks on Gardera and quantification of should we think about this story as like singular but like not directly?
We can think about this as some trigonometric version of it. Because then is the degeneration of XXX, and the Hamiltonians of XXX are the images of commuting generators.
Okay. So is there a map from one?
well, it is locally around the unity in the torus. So locally, it is what we have to do. But locally, it is something more.
I have one question about the very beginning of your talk. So you mentioned that you can consider Yang-Yang as a deformation of two different objects. One is the universal developing algebra of GFT,
right.
And another is deformation of functions on the group, but not the whole current group, but on this G1, right?
Right.
But it seems that the kind of the analog of the G1 should be rather the universal developing of T times G of T.
You see, these are two dual things, because G of T is
formally simplifying the function. Just to put a
maybe